I'm OBX Toycat and welcome back to another second channel video. Today I'm in Leeds, Yorkshire, which is a part of England everyone can agree is the north. But why is there a north of England and a south of England? And why is there a big divide between the two? But you know, in terms of economics, socially, politically, etc., I figured I would take a small crack at answering at least some of that, maybe with like an American analogy or two, so you can understand a little bit more about England. Or if I'm just saying a lot of stuff that you don't care about, then you know, I'm in front of Leeds Town Hall right now, and I think it's rather pretty. I mean, it's a city, not a town, so I don't know why it has a town hall. But yeah, it's big, it's nice, and it's got an England flag in front of it, and isn't that lovely? But yeah, with that said, let's get straight into already, shall we? And let's start with the very, very brief history, which kind of explains the whole economic thing, because you can explain this for hours if you really want to. But in very brief, because I'm just here vlogging and talking to a camera, the general kind of gist of it is that even though the UK is a tertiary economy and is based on services and this and this and this, the North historically and generally it was more heavy towards manufacturing and primary resource extraction like coal, steel, manufacturing stuff, whereas the South was more about trade and services and all that sort of stuff. Additionally, the South is centered around London, which is now one of the big financial and just, you know, I guess one of the big cities of the world, whereas the North is kind of spread out amongst more cities. There's Leeds, there's Sheffield, there's Manchester, there's Liverpool, there's all the cities that are kind of geographically spread out. Anyway, the reason that's relevant is because, you know, if you just look at the economic thing by itself, because obviously nowadays, even to some extent in the recent history, manufacturing and primary resources just isn't as profitable as other stuff. You might say, oh yeah, so therefore the South just has more money and therefore, you know, it's like a rich poor divide thing. But it isn't as simple as that. There are parts of the South, particularly seaside towns, where there just isn't much money because their industry has depleted at the same rate. So why is it like a big divide between the North and the South when it's not just about economics? It's not even about the politics about it. Because if you look, you know, the Thatcher was the big, divisive leader that kind of cemented the North votes one way, the South votes one way. It's the same thing as in America, where, you know, the whole, like, Democrat-Republican switch happened because of, the laws that they tried to pass in the 60s about what the South states could do. When you try to, like, make a region do something against its perceived kind of will, it does create kind of, like, a political kind of combination, as well as that kind of coming. Because even, like I said, even though there are rich parts of the North and poor parts of the South, there's still the generalizations about both of them. And then this gets compounded further when there is kind of a social kind of element to it, too. It's a really interesting thing that can't truly be pinned down to anything, but people from northern cities, like Leeds, have a much easier time picking up accents from other northern cities, again, any of the ones I mentioned before, than they would picking up an accent from the south. There's like a resistance to it built into people, which again, is really interesting. It happens the other way around too. People from the south don't pick up northern accents generally when they go to the north. And again, when you combine all these sorts of things, as well as the fact that people see themselves this way, you kind of arrive at the state where you have lots of groups of people that can live in the same country, but still think they have their own little region. You know, in the south, like in where I was from, which is the south, they'll be like, oh yeah, he's from up north. And you see signs here, they're just like, to the south, and they say to the north. And there's just kind of this like embedding of it into what people believe and what they think. And that's how you lead to parts of the country that are different things. Because even though a country to the world tries to see it united, I mean, the UK is literally made of four countries, so it gets a bit messier than that. But even though countries kind of try to see united to the world, you forget that there are lots of different parts, lots of different interests, with lots of different people within that thing. So, like, you think of Belgium, you don't think that there's three parts of Belgium. They literally speak different languages in the north of Belgium to the south of Belgium. When you think of any country, if you think of Germany, you forget there's an east and west Germany where the east is still a lot poorer because of historical reasons, and it kind of goes for lots of reasons like that. But the really interesting point about this is while I was researching this, the north-south divide in England, because in England in particular, it is kind of a big deal, and it is, like, this big social thing, it happens in every other country in the UK too. It happens in Scotland. The north of Scotland, the Highlands, is, you know, very, very different to the south. There's a lot higher rates of, like, poverty, etc. there. It happens in the north and the valleys of Wales compared to the south of Wales. You know, there are richer and poorer parts there. And it's really, really intrigued me that it is always north-south, because it's not even just the UK. It's not just the three countries. It's not like there's something we do here that just, you know, favours the south or favors the north. There is actually a north-south divide in the world too, and in those terms, then pretty much every rich country exists in the northern hemisphere of the world. Even though there is only 20% of the world's population living in the northern hemisphere, something like 80% of the world's GDP and wealth is made there. And that is really interesting. Why is there always a north-south divide in the world? You can't say for sure, but it happens everywhere. It happens not only in the UK, not only in Belgium, but it happens on a worldwide level too. Is there just something about humans where we tend to gravitate to the same hemisphere? Is it just the sort of thing where, like, people self-selectively chose themselves there and then, like, it built itself up like that? I don't know for sure, but there's one interesting point that you get from this that people don't really ever address in the real world when they're talking about discourse and how the world should be more fair or less fair or something. But people are always talking about, you know, the one big issue that everyone bases their, you know, ideology on is, should there be more, like, distribution of the wealth from rich to poor or poor to rich or whatever? Should there be more of this distribution or less? But people never think about it as a regional issue too. Like, there are parts of this exact same country that are incredibly poor. There are parts where they're incredibly rich. If you look at, like, the richest, like, parts of the UK compared to poorest, it is a stark difference. Is that something you care about, or do you just try to fix it and leave that? I don't know. It's something that hasn't been addressed really since the 70s, and no one's really cared about since then. And it's something that I guess is an issue for everyone. But anyway, today I'm in the north. Leeds is actually one of the richest cities in the north, as it turns out. And I just figured I'd ponder, explain the whole kind of history behind the whole thing. I mean, there's like a wedding happening back there, because like, when I started like standing here and like looking at the video stuff, there was no one there. So that's interesting. But yeah, I was just kind of pondering like, why is the north different and all of this sort of thing? And it really comes down to history combined with like a social factor which comes from the history. And really, I think with any issue, I think like pretty much everything we get down to this channel, if you look at something and you go back far enough, anything that seems illogical, like that there is a north and south of the same country, can be explained. Except why the north of the world is richer than the south, besides like, I don't know, we colonize more. But yeah, with that said, hope you all enjoyed this video. Maybe I should go to the wedding or something, but no, I'm gonna go check out some other Leeds stuff. I don't even know what it is here, honestly. And I'll see you all in the next one. Goodbye.